lift on 1, 2, 3, lift.
Port Arthur firefighter Jacob Weeren is in the rescue basket.
Y'all fixing to have the weight, okay?
I'm coming out.
It's his first time training for a high-angle rescue. And it's definitely an exercise in trust.
Of course, you feel secure because you've got plenty of ropes, knots tied to you, but you're not in any control. So the first time over, you're just kind of relying on your crew.
Most on this crew are first-timers at high-angle rescue training.
Our department right now is going through a big transition due to retirements and stuff like that, so a lot of the younger guys are stepping up to the plate, and we're training them to take our old guys' places.
Y'all start backing up, Ken.
Training like this is necessary in Port Arthur, a city dotted by refineries and with a large port.
We back up the rescue teams in the plants and refineries, and we do a lot of rescues off of ships and drilling rigs.
Today they're practicing rescues from 20 feet. Tomorrow they'll be practicing rescues from 100 feet.
If you don't have the training on something like this, it's when it's gonna come back, it's gonna bite you.
Training that goes well beyond fighting fires.
We're no longer just a fire department. We're more of a fire rescue. We do medical, we do hazmat, we do high angle rescue, in addition to the fire calls.
All right, y'all don't pull anything yet, okay?
Practice that saves lives.
It's good to be a part of the team. Good guys over here.
In a dangerous situation.
Black on the ground.
In Port Arthur.
Lines are clear, pull up.
Lauren Huet, Fox 4 News.
Give me a tag. Okay, you got tag on.